Welcome back to the channel where we continue on our Power BI series. And this time around, we're going to take a look at data visualization in Power BI. We're going to create a KPI card and a multi-row card, show you some of the use cases and how to do the formatting and which data fields are required. It's the multi-row card and the KPI card data visualization in Power BI. Back in Power BI, and today we're going to talk about data visualization, and we are going to make a multi-row card and a KPI card. One of the things when you're first starting off in Power BI and you get to that fourth stage of your Power BI workflow, which is data visualization, you're going to see all of these different chart types and visualizations, and it can be confusing for which one you want to use. Now, always remember, you're trying to tell the story. And also remember who your audience is. If it's going to be more of a report where they're looking at it and you want a quick highlight, cards and multi-row cards can be very effective. If it's going to be more for a manager or an executive who likes to drill down, then you're going to want to start using some of your filters, some of your bookmarks, your matrices, and things like that. So always think about the audience, think about the role of the report and the graphs. And today we're going to make around, this is the finished view, we're going to make a basic multi-row card, then we're going to show you how to format it out, and then we're going to make a KPI card and show you some of the different components, data components of the KPI card as we continue along with data visualization in Power BI. Working in Power BI, and we're going to start to make out our report and our dashboard. And what we want to include when we're analyzing this YouTube channel, and I was working with them, they wanted to see some of the quick highlights from the recent month. So when you're looking at a multi-row card, which is part of your visual gallery, and it's right at the top, it's a multi-row card. And when you select that, basically this only requires one field of data. Now, we already did a video on a card and that requires one field. This allows you to highlight two or three fields of data. So we're going to add the data. And first off, this time around, we're going to add views, revenue, and minutes. Now remember, this is a YouTube channel, so they might want to see their total views. And then we're going to take a look at their total revenue. And then we're going to add in total minutes. So this will give a quick snapshot for the owner of this YouTube channel so that they can take a look. And once they refresh the data, they can see how they're doing. Now in this example, we're looking at the lifetime views of this channel, total revenue, total minutes, and then from there you can start to build out your visual. Now for your options on the properties, so we're going to make a copy of this, and what we're going to do now is start to format this a little bit, and you can do different things with your formatting. We're going to go to the more options. And you actually get quite a few options on the formatting, including the size of the visual. So let's say if we want to make this a 250 by a 200 for the width, a little bit taller than narrower, or you can actually grab onto the corner and bring that down as well. So now we've got a 174 by 200. That is the size and positioning options. For the background, currently, it's a white background. You can choose a different color if you want to add color to your background. Maybe you want a little bit more transparency as well. So those are some of the different options with the background. Then you can add on a title. Right now it is off, but maybe you wanted to have something like lifetime metrics, because you want to see the lifetime metrics of this channel. That could be a title. And you can also work with the size of that if you want to make that a little bit better, bigger, if you want to have a different color text. So you've got lots of options on the formatting. And remember, for each chart, the options that on the formatting really revolve around what's included in that chart. So you've got a title, you've got a size, you've got some of the different values. So now we're going to take a look at the call-out values. These are the actual numbers. So the 1,888,000, we could make that bigger, all three of them bigger, maybe a 14-point. We could change the font to a Seago Bold. If we wanted to change the color of that, we could change that as well. So you've got options on the formatting. And then for the category labels, we're going to make those smaller because we want the numbers to pop more than the actual metric. So again, what you're trying to highlight here along with the card, the number becomes valuable. And also for some of the different cards themselves, you could take a look at the border position, the accent bar if you want the border position at the top. You could do it on the right side. So these add some different elements to the actual multi-row card. So that is a look at how you create a multi-row card and some of the uses for a multi-row card. You could do up to, you know, 4, 5, 6 values in your multi-row card. Anything more than that, you may be looking at it, you know, might want to do some individual cards. But what allows you to do is quickly put together some important metrics into one visual without having to create and copy multiple visuals like you did with the card. We've made the multi-row card. Now let's work on the KPI card. And the KPI card is one of the better visuals to use to show progress against a goal. So when you're looking at the KPI card, again, it's up in your visuals. We're going to go to the gallery and choose the KPI card. And when you start to build out your visual for the KPI card, you're going to notice three different components that you need. You need a value, you need a trend axis, and you need a target. And that's really what makes up the magic of the KPI card when you're trying to really highlight one value and then comparing that to the target for that metric. So the metric, again, is just another word for the number that you're trying to visualize. In this case around, we are going to try to take a look at total revenue and compare it to the previous month revenue. So the total revenue is going to be our value. And nothing happens when you put that in there. When you add the trend axis, which is the time series element, that is when you will start to see the visual actually show up. Remember, measures are not actually created with the engine until you actually put them in a visual. So for this one, we're going to go with the start of the month as our trend axis. We're going to make this a little bit bigger. And what you have now is total revenue by start of the month. Now, what we're going to add in is the target. And the target is going to be the previous month's revenue. This channel is trying to grow their revenue on YouTube every single month. So we're going to search for previous month's revenue, and we're going to bring that into the matrix. And now we see that the goal in the current month was $1,600, and the previous month the revenue was $1,000. So there's a 60% increase. And what this is important for is at a quick glance, they can see how they're trending against previous month's revenue. Now for the formatting options, again, you can add or remove visual elements. We're going to take a look at the formatting options. First off, again, you have the size. One of the things I always try to do is make a standard size. So we'll go 350 by 400. And then you can place that wherever you want on the chart. So those are your size options. For the title, it defaulted to the title. If we didn't want to have a title, which it's recommended here because somebody, again, you always want the 5-second rule. Can they guess that? So we're going to have current month revenue. You want something that's descriptive, yet not too long of a title. And so we're going to use just current month revenue. And we may want to center that. And we're going to make that a little bit bigger. And also, that'll get us a title. Now the callout value, it defaulted to 45. We're going to make that a little bit smaller. And we're going to also change the font. Now, one of the things you want to do as you start to build out your visuals, if you have a brand font, you're going to want to start to use similar fonts. You don't want every metric to have a different font. So in this one, we used the Sego Bold for the font in the multi-row cards. And that's what you're going to want to do just for consistency. So whichever one you're going to start to use, you're going to want to continue to use that font across the report just for consistency purposes to make it more readable. Now the default value went to 1.64 thousand. If you wanted to have the actual revenue, you could do none. So it literally brings it out to the cents. So we'll leave that there. Previous month was $1,018, and now you know exactly where you're at this month, $1,638. You could add some icons. Right now, the icons in the background, we can make those a little bit bigger, or we could make those smaller. So we're gonna leave that at 8 point. And then the trend axis, if you didn't want that, this tells you which direction. Higher is better. In this case, it's revenue. But if this was something like returns, you'd want it to be a smaller number. So you could reverse that. You could also work on the transparency. It's at 20%. If you want a little bit lighter green, you could make that a little bit fainter, depending on the rest of the chart. So that is how you make a KPI card. It's valuable for highlighting one specific metric, and then you're comparing it to what the goal is or the target value for that month. So that is a look at how to make a multi-row card and a KPI card. It's part of the fourth stage of your Power BI workflow, which is the data visualization, and you do this in the report menu. Make sure to watch some of our other videos on data visualization in this series on Power BI.